Cardamom is one of the world's most expensive spices after saffron and vanilla. It has a sweet, burning taste and a very distinctive spicy odor. Because of its variety of uses gained reputation as the queen of spices. Cardamom is a spice made from the seeds of two different species in the genera Elateria and Amomum in the family Zingiberaceae. Propagation from seed. Purchase seeds specifically designed for planting, as opposed to just cracking open a couple pods from the pantry. If planting outdoors, plant your seeds 1/2 to 1 inch apart, about 1/8 inch deep in a partially shady place. They prefer rich humus soil that's slightly acidic. Alternatively, you can plant cardamom seeds in a pot, so you can bring the plant indoors to overwinter. How to grow? Make sure your plants are always partially shaded. And most importantly, keep the ground moist. They do not like soil that dries out. Water regularly if rain is not plentiful. You might also give your plants a misting now and then, since they are natively accustomed to high humidity. If you have planted cardamom in a container, bring it inside when temperatures drop below 50 degrees Fahrenheit. Place the pot in a spot that gets 6 to 8 hours of bright but filtered light. Growing tips. Water, water, water. Not too much sun. Not too chilly. Purchasing options. You won't find a wide variety of cardamom buying choices here in the India. In fact, your options pretty much boil down to cardamom seeds or a live cardamom plant. Managing pests and disease. You may see thrips on your plants, which you can treat with traps. You may also see evidence of detrimental nematodes, which manifests in poor growth and damaged-looking plants. If you have a nematode infestation, you may have to destroy your plants and treat the soil by solarization or with a chemical nematicide to try to get rid of the pests. Disease. These plants may be bothered by oomycetes or fungi, prevent spread by keeping the growing area clean and removing dead plant matter. You can also treat these problems with a fungicide. Harvesting. At the base of the stalks, the plant forms long bracts of flowers that then develop into seed pods. These seed pods may be harvested by hand in the fall, 30 to 40 days after flowering. Harvest timing can be tricky. You want to harvest the pods just before they are fully ripe and begin to split and release their seeds. Start harvesting at the base of each stem and move up the stem, leaving for another day any pods that resist.